Hello everyone, here's what this video is about. First of all, why bring up abuse on my page posts? Secondly, did I disclose too much of my personal life and past? And third, with this past that I've just disclosed, should I coach? Number one, why bring up sexual abuse on my page? I believe it is important that we become aware of abuse. We don't understand it and we don't recognize it. Just like many other people, I used to think that sexual abuse is about a person being raped late at night by a stranger who accosted them on a dark alley somewhere in the city. But that's only the extreme end of abuse. The actual truth is that abuse is much more ubiquitous, so much more common, much more everyday in our relationships, and it looks like what I described in my letter. In case somebody around us went through abuse in their past, we might not know how to behave and how to support them. I addressed this in the letter that I described, where I said that my friends and my family at the time, nobody even sat me down and asked me, "What is going on with you? How are you feeling?" And this is unfortunately common because we don't understand abuse. We don't know how to recognize it. And we don't understand what the person that's been abused goes through. That's what you will also discover in my letter, as I mentioned about the therapist and the man that actually supported me and helped me to loosen up the charge that I had around abuse. If we have been through abuse ourselves, in most cases, we're never aware that we've been abused because we don't recognize it. Therefore, we never think that, wow, we might be abused. And last but not least, why talk about abuse? Well, if you're a victim of abuse, as I was, let me share with you what the contribution is. Ignorance about abuse, and then self-worth issues. Number two, did I disclose too much from my past and from my personal life? In a previous post, I was talking there about how we bring up our erotic background. So how do we talk about our past? And I was advising people not to get into too many details, just to stick to the specifics, leave people out, and so on. So if I am to be compared with that post and what I suggested there, then I broke my own rule. I did not keep my own word. Absolutely. If you want to judge me on that, then definitely by that standard, I failed big time. However, if you want to know why somebody breaks their own rule or their own word, here is why. I was answering a question about how I kept motivated while things were not working out. I didn't want to give a platitude. I wanted to share my own story and say, this is what I worked through and this is how I kept motivated. Secondly, my intention was to bring awareness to the sexual abuse that is much more common than what we might think. And it's important that we get an image. That's why I went into those details. Third, believe me when I say this, I did not share all the details from that story. The majority of details were told in my therapy sessions and they'll stay there. And no, I didn't disclose everything. Last but not least, I was not talking about this with an actual lover. I wasn't saying anything to intimidate anyone, so I was not doing any of that. And third, with such a past, should I coach? Now, nobody contested me like this. I'm the one that is putting myself on the back burner or the hot seat and asking this question because I think that's relevant. I think it lurks in the back of many people's minds, so I just want to bring it up front and address it head on. First of all, my coaches, my teachers, my trainers, whenever I went to work with them in my past, some were in marriages, some were being celibate at the time, some were dating multiple people at the time. Their marital status or their relationship status did not affect their capacity to train students, to certify specialists, or even to coach clients. And nobody, when we came to the training, nobody asked for their background. It's like, we didn't care. We cared about their ability to do something for us. In terms of coaching, what I want you to realize is that our ability to hold space and to bring the people that we work with in a place where they can look at themselves and we ask them questions meant for them to answer and to discover where they're at and what they can do for themselves, this is not a skill that you learn in relationships. Somebody can be celibate like their entire lives, but they can hold space and facilitate this process for many people. And somebody can be married with children, but they might not be so good at facilitating healing, growth, and learning for other people. One last detail here. In the Jordan post with the couple looking at the temple, I also mentioned that there is a reason for which therapists are not allowed to work with friends, lovers, immediate family, because their work relationship would not be objective. So you need to be able to not take sides. You need to be able to look at the situation objectively and therefore help the person from a neutral space. So your lovers, your friends, your acquaintances might simply not be, even if they could hold space for others, they might not be the best solution for you simply because they have a stake in it. Small or bigger, doesn't matter. They're not objective. This is it. I hope that the video helps you. See you.